So maybe we'll start. We have 15 minutes remaining. Okay. So main RTOS code, I have already explained. In the main RTOS code, you have to just initialize the RTOS. Okay. Then make aware about your task, like button task and the your level task. And also, also do the its priorities. That is, which task is very important. So level task having the lowest priority and button task having the highest priority. Okay. Now, second thing is how to write the actual program. That is, actual program for the task. So to write a program for task, you have to give the name of the task. Okay. That is file button task. And after that, in curly bracket, you have to write a file true. File true. And then again, curly bracket. And then you write down block this task until user pushes a button. That means this task is not going to execute still user presses the button externally. Okay. And if it presses the button externally, you give the quick response to the user. Okay. So that kind of the code you can write into the this task called as a button task. Now just see if you understood how to write a task one, you are able to write a task two, three, four, five. So you are able to write any type of task if you understood how to write a single task. So that is how simple. Okay, you have the main RTOS program and you have the task. If you understood how to write a single task, you are able to write a task 2, 3, 4. So number of tasks you can write. Okay. Now, similar way, we will go for the second task that is called as a level task. Okay, level task. Now, what should be the change in the level task? The name of the task becomes file P level task. Okay. And what is the priority of this task? That is a low priority. Okay, the priority of this task is a low priority. And then file true. Okay. Now what is done in the level task? We are reading the levels of the floats in a tank. So I have the float sensors, and by using that float sensor, I can calculate the level of my tank. And then second statement is calculate the average float levels. Okay, because let I have a single tank. And I will use three sensors. One is at the bottom, another is at the middle, and at the top. I have three float sensors in a single tank. So I will take whatever the average, I will calculate the average float level. Okay, this is for single task. Single tank, then I have tank 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so I can find out the, or I can calculate the average float level, okay, of your tank. Next. Do some interminable calculation, do more interminable calculation, do at more interminable calculations, and then figure out which tank to do next. Okay. That is, let I have done it for tank 0, then I have tank 2, tank 3. So you calculate all the average tank levels, okay, of each tank. Okay. So corresponding practical code you can write here, but for the sake of understanding, only the pseudo, that is, statements are written. That means you are allowed to write a statement rather than the actual code, okay, in RTOS, okay, in theory also, not in practical, but in theory, okay. So if they have asked you code to write a RTOS program for underground tank monitoring system, you are allowed to write this kind of program, okay. It's called as a pseudo code, okay, or pseudo random code. So these are the two tasks. Just see, it's very simple, button task and level task. So you have to just give the name of that task, okay? And inside actual code just get changed. That is, in button task, you have to wait till the user presses the button, okay? First condition. And second, whenever it presses the button, you have to quickly respond to that task, okay? Now what is done in level task? In level task, you have to read the float levels in the tank, and you have to calculate the average float level. Okay, maybe for tank 1, tank 2, tank 3, tank 4, likewise. Okay, so that is what done in the this task. So this is what the code. Just see. So how many codes are there? I have only three parts. One is called as a main RTOS code. Okay. Second is called as the first task, button task, and third is a level task. Okay. So this much of code you have to write. Okay. Now we'll see how we switch from one task to another task, okay, by using this diagram. So this diagram is very useful for the understanding. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Or I have to make it. Okay. Maybe I think now it is visible. So just see. Microprocessor respond to a button under an ATOS. Okay. So now this this is what called as a some graphical way to understand the ATOS. Okay. How your microprocessor will execute the first task, that is a level task, and the second task is a button task, and how your microprocessor will switch from running state to block state, and from block state to the ready to run state, and how your task switches from ready to run state to again running state. Okay, so this is nothing but the task state transition diagram. That means how your microcontroller will switch from one task to another task. Okay, and what should be its state. Okay, so that you can understand by using this diagram. So if you are not understood the code, okay, but you will understood the working of your ATOS by using this diagram. So again, be attentive for this diagram. So maybe 5 minutes will require. Now just see, there are two tasks, okay? So that I have told, fee level task. Now what is the priority of fee level task? What is the priority of the fee level task?
Low level.
Low level, so it's a low priority task. And I have another task, that is fee button task. Now what is the priority of button task? It's a high priority. Okay, so initially, let's see, whenever you switch on your embedded system, now I have the question, that is, out of these two tasks, which task will be executed by the microcontroller? So this is your first overall question. I have two tasks. First task, level task, which is a low priority, and second task, button task, is a highest priority. The my question is, whenever I just power on my embedded systems, okay, so which task is in execution by the microcontroller?
Higher
one or lower one? Someone left. Okay, not bothering about the highest and lowest. So which one? Okay, I have in chat, I have, okay, from Kakde, I have one question, that is, which software are used for ATOS? Okay, just see, software is not used for ATOS. ATOS itself is a software. Okay, so it is one kind of OS.
सर हॅलो हॅलो सर म्हणजे कोड रन करण्यासाठी कोणतं सॉफ्टवेअर असं म्हणते मी
हा कोड रन करण्यासाठी आपल्याला किल वरती आपण करतो किल आणि किल मायक्रोविजन एक आहे आणि सेकंड आहे एसपीजे सिस्टीमच एसपीजे कंपायलर ओके सो किल इज अ फॉरेन कंपायलर अँड एसपीजे कंपायलर इज अ इंडियाज फर्स्ट कंपायलर सो we will execute our code by using SPJ compilers, okay, at the time of practicals. Okay, so you can use SPJ compiler or also KIL compiler, okay, for executing the ATOS. Okay, but you have to put the ATOS into the microcontroller. Akshadala, you have to copy the ATOS into the microcontroller. Hello. Hello, any question?
No, sir.
Okay, so the answer is you have to use SPJ compiler or the KIL compiler, okay, for writing the code. Okay, means whatever the code right now I have shown, you can write that code by using a either KIL compiler. Okay, like in third year you have written the code, maybe I think I don't know whether you have used or not. Like assembly language, you are not going to use assembly, but rather than we are using a KIL compiler, okay, on which you have to write the code, or SPJ compiler. So whatever the code I have shown, you can write this code on these two softwares. Okay. Now we'll see the working of this particular ATOS. Okay. So first is my first question is, whenever I switch on my embedded system, okay, so always remember my system will always execute a low priority task. Okay, my RTOS or my embedded system will always execute a low priority task. So which is a low priority task? It's a level task. So just see this this gray section, which observe ke lesare here, this gray section, complete gray section will show that during this time, initial time, and this is the total duration for which the level task is in execution. Okay, so level task is in execution, and what is done by using level task, that is shown by this arrow. Okay, so this arrow shows that fee level task is busy calculating the tank levels. File, now what is the status of button task? Whether your button task is in a running state or block state or ready to run state?
Ready to run.
Ready to run. But what is the definition of ready to run state? That is, the task is ready to run, but the CPU is not available. So whether this is the case? No. Here, button task is not ready to run because it is waiting for some external to or some external things to happen. What is the external thing? That is, some external user will come and then press the button, and only then it will get unblocks. Okay, so level task is in a running state, and that time the fee button task is blocked. Are you getting why this is blocked? Because it is unblocks only if some user presses the button. If no one has pressed the button, so this task is not going to execute at any time. Okay, so such a kind of tasks are called as a block task, because they are waiting for something to happen. So what is something to happen? That is, someone has to press the button, otherwise automatically button should not be get pressed. Okay, so that kind of task is called as a block state. So in our case, the level task is in a running state, and that time the button task is in a blocked state. So that is what shown by this total gray area. Okay, and there is one arrow. It shows that level task is busy in calculating the tank level, while your button task is blocked. Okay, why blocked? Because user has not pressed the button, and still user will press the button. It will not get unblocked, and once it get unblocked, only then it will move from blocked state to ready to run state. Deshmukh, are you getting or not?
Yes, sir.
Whenever user presses the button, only then it get unblocked, and once it get unblocked, it has to move to the ready to run state. Here your scheduler will check the priority of the running state and the ready to run state. Okay, now this is for the this particular duration. Okay, and there is then this diagram shows one transaction from bottom to top. Okay, so this shows that some user, that is the second statement, the user press the button. So now let some user comes and he has pressed the button, what will happen? Okay, so RTOS switches the microprocessor to button task 5, because the button task having the highest priority. That is what we have defined in the RTOS code, because button task having the highest priority. So RTOS will switches the microprocessor or microcontroller to button task. Now that time the state of your previous task, which is a level task, that is again ready to run. Okay, is it blocked? No. Okay, are you getting or not? That is, the first task is running. Okay, it is not completely executed. Level task is in running state, and after some time there is an external user who presses the button. Because of this, what happened? The microprocessor or microcontroller switches the control of the CPU from the level task to the button task. Okay, and why he has switches? Because the button task having the highest priority. Okay, now we have to see the state of the two tasks. That is, what is the state of the button task? Now button task comes into the running state, and the uncompleted task, level task, whose priority is less than the button task, that's why he is switching from running state to ready to run. Okay, and the button task having the highest priority compared to the level task. That's why it comes from block state to ready to run, and from ready to run to running state. Okay, so that is what happened at the second instant. So in the second instant, what happened? Whenever user presses the button, ATA switches from microprocessor to button task, since its priority is higher than the level task. Okay, so right now the button task is in a running state and your level task is in a ready to run state. Okay, because it is not completed still. Okay, now again this gray transition shows that, this gray area shows that the button task is does everything it needs to do to respond to the button. That is, once the button is pressed, what is our task? You display the levels of all the tanks on the LCD. So whatever things you require, that is done in between. Okay. Now once this task is over, that is once the highest priority task, which is button task, is over. Now again, what happened? Again, you have to switch from the. So here one arrow is shown. So this shows that once button task finishes its work, it blocks again. Okay. So what is the state of now button task? It is going from running state to block state. Okay, that means right now the CPU is available. Now which task having the highest priority right now? The level task. Okay, so ATA switches the microprocessor back to the level task. So that is what's shown by using this transition. So this transition shows from up to bottom. Okay, and now again there is a third gray area. This shows that the level task is in execution. Okay, so this is how your microprocessor will switch from the level task to the button task, and again button task to the level task. Okay, so this indicates that how your task will switch from the running state, that is ready to run, to running state, from running state to block state, and from block state to again ready to run state, and from ready to run state to running states. Okay, so this is how or what happens in the RTOS. Okay, so based upon this, there are two types of kernel. One is called as a preemptive type of kernel, and another is called as a non-preemptive type of kernel. Okay, so maybe we don't have the time. It's a 12 o'clock. Okay, but I think you have understood this. Okay, you have to just understood this application. Okay, you have tank, you have two tasks, you have the task. How to write a task in RTOS, task one, task two, okay, and then you have to write the main RTOS. Here you have to add your actual task, okay, and you have to start the RTOS, okay. And this is what the diagram that will help you to understand the switching of your task from the in between all these three tasks, okay. I think you have understood. I don't know. So just give me some confirmation so that we will stop. Otherwise, maybe in next lecture, again, I will refresh this application. Just give me the confirmation whether you are getting the things. Okay, yes. Okay, then we'll stop here. If you have problem, again, I will explain the RTOS code